Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah alladhi bidhikrihi tatma'innu al-qulub wa bi rahmatihi tughfaru adh-dhunub wa bi karamihi tustaru al-'uyub wa bi quwwatihi tufarraju al-kurub. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين ولي الصالحين ونشهد أن سيدنا مولانا محمد عبده ورسوله وخليله وشفيعه طب القلوب ودوائها ونور الأبصار وديائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها. قال حسان: أحسن منك لم تر قط عيني وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء. خلقت مبرئا من كل عيب كأنك قد خلقت كما تشاء. قال الله تعالى: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه سيدنا محمد عدد كل حرف جرى به القلم. وقال تعالى: قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم. عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال: كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة إلا من أبى. قيل: يا رسول الله، ومن يأبى؟ قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: من أطاعني دخل الجنة، ومن عصاني فقد أبى، أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. الحمد لله. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said in a hadith that لا تطروني كما أطرت النصارى ابن مريم، إنما أنا عبد الله ورسوله. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, don't exaggerate in my praise like how the نصارى exaggerate on عيسى بن مريم. For indeed I am only the servant of Allah and His Messenger. Means we don't make him Allah, you know. Like how the Christians make Isa alayhi salam Allah. And like how the Christians make Isa ibn Maryam, Yadu Billah, the son of Allah. But who is our Nabi? This we have to know. You know, when we know something, then we want to follow if there is some good in it. And if there is some bad in it, we don't want to follow. But knowing something that this is good for me and you're not following also, it's another problem. Who is our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Firstly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, Salamun ala Nuhin fil alameen. Salam upon Nuh alayhi salam. In the whole alam, in the whole realm. Salamun ala Musa wa Harun. Salamun ala Ilyasin. Allah Ta'ala says, wa salamun ala al-mursaleen also. Salam upon Anbiya alayhi salam. It means every Anbiya is great. But when it comes to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah Ta'ala says by emphasizing, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu inna. Verily, indeed, without doubt, Allah and His Malaika, yusalluna ala al-Nabi. They send salawat upon Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. This is one of the greatest specialties of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, when you check your Arabic, you see what is yusalluna, you feel istimra. From azal, from without beginning and without end, Allah and His Malaika, they just send salawat upon Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we better send salawat upon Nabi for our own good. Because Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Man sallallahu alayhi wa ahidatan, sallallahu alayhi wa ashra. You send salawat, one salawat upon me, Allah Ta'ala sends 10 salawat upon you. Means Allah Ta'ala sends 10 rahmat upon you. And you have to remember, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is independent from our salawat. And we are not independent from sending salawat to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are in need of sending salawat upon Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who is our Nabi? Allah Ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ عَهِدْنَا إِلَىٰ آدَمُ فَنَسِيَ وَلَمْ نَجِدْ لَهُ عَزْمًا. We took pledge with Adam alayhi salam, but Adam alayhi salam forgot. He got no azimah, you know. He didn't take it seriously. Allah Ta'ala asked him, Uskun anta wa zawjuka al-jannah wa la taqraba hadhihi ash-shajara fatakuna min adh-dhalimin. Go into Jannah, O Adam, you and your wife, but do not go close to that tree. Adam forgot. He went to the tree and then Allah sent him down. But when he comes to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah Ta'ala said to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, سَنُقِرُؤُكَ فَلَا تَنْسَى. Carry on. We will always remind you and you won't forget. He is human, but this is what Allah Ta'ala said in the Quran. Do your job. سَنُقِرُؤُكَ فَلَا تَنْسَى. We will definitely remind you all the time and you won't forget. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then, when it comes to Nuh alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Nuh said to Allah, Rabbi inna bni min ahli wa inna wa'daka al-haq wa anta arhamur rahimin. Oh Allah, you're drowning everyone, but there's my son around here now. And your promise is true. Allah Ta'ala called Nuh alayhi salam, Inni a'iduka an takuna min al-jahilin. Hey Nuh, la tas'alni ma laysa laka bihi ilm. Don't ask me something that you have no knowledge of. And I'm warning you that you should become those who are jahil. Ibrahim alayhi salam also made the dua. وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ وَفِرْ لِأَبِي إِنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الضَّالِّينَ. Ibrahim made dua for his father because he promised his father. And Ibrahim alayhi salam asked Allah Ta'ala, Oh Allah, don't disgrace me on the day of judgment. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Don't disgrace me on the day of judgment, on the day of Qiyamah. And every Nabi has some worry on the day of Qiyamah because of some one mistake that he do. So much so, even on the day of Qiyamah, every Nabi will be saying, Nafsi, Nafsi, myself, myself. You know, after when we go to them. Only Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will come in, and everybody comes to Nabi, Nabi will say, Ana sahib al-maqam. Ana sahib al-maqam. Ana sayyid wuldi Adam wa la fakhar. I am yawm al-qiyamah wa la fakhar. I am the leader of the son of Adam. Without pride. So every Nabi gets some worry for the day of Qiyamah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said concerning Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Yawma la yukhzi Allahu al-Nabi wal-ladhina amanu ma'ah. Nuruhum yas'a bayna aydihim wa bi'aymanihim. Allah Ta'ala says, the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not disgrace Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Remember, Ibrahim has made dua, Oh Allah, don't disgrace me on the day of Qiyamah. Nuh alayhi salam has made dua, Oh Allah, my son. Allah scolded him. Allah said, concerning Nabi, يَوْمَ لَا يُخْزِي اللَّهُ النَّبِيُّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ نُورُهُمْ يَسْعَى بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبِأَيْمَانِهِمْ. Such a Nabi we got. The day when Allah won't disgrace Nabi and those who believe with him. Allah didn't even say his Ahl Bayt also. There is some special status and greatness about his Ahl Bayt, topic of its own. Then when you come, Musa alayhi salam, Allah asked him, وَمَا أَعْجَلَكَ عَنْ قَوْمِكَ يَا مُوسَى. You know when Musa went for the commandments, then 30 days Allah made it, another 10 days, then 40 days. Allah, as Musa, why you so hasty, you left your people behind, Bani Israel? Musa alayhi salam said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbi, ajiltu ilayka li tarda. Oh Allah, I came hastily. I came fast so that you will be pleased with me. When it comes to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْتِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Don't ask. Redmate Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm just using the word redmate. He is beyond redmate also. Allah ta'ala said to him, وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْتِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Don't stress about my pleasure. Very soon, your Rabb will give you and you will be happy. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Musa alayhi salam, Allah ta'ala asked him, go to Fir'aun. Idhab ila Fir'aun. Innahu tagha. Go to Fir'aun. He has transgressed. Musa has to ask Allah, qala rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Oh Allah, open my chest. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri. Oh Allah, you make it easy for me. Untie the knot on my tongue. Musa could not speak properly, you know. That's why Allah sent him in Haro. When it comes to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah ta'ala said to Nabi in the Quran, Alam nasharah laka sadrak. You don't have to ask like how Musa asked. But Allah is saying, telling us, Alam nasharah laka sadrak. Didn't we open your chest? You know what it means is to take out all, you know, grief, all dirt, all filth from the chest. Alam nasharah laka sadrak. Did we purify your chest? Did we open your chest for you? Did we make things in? Wa wada'na anka wizrak. All that burden upon you, we took it out from you. Alladhi anqadha dhahrak wa rafa'na laka dhikrak. We lifted your status. Wherever you mention Allah, you have to mention Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. You know when it's Fajr time here? We made the adhan. It's Fajr time somewhere else. As the time goes. We made the adhan here, next few minutes. The other place is making the adhan also. They're just taking the name of Allah and the name of Rasulullah. They finish next few minutes. The next place takes the adhan and the iqama. It goes like that. The whole dunya, every morning, every evening, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. This is our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah ta'ala made everything ready for him. This is our Nabi. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍ دَعْوَةٌ مُسْتَجَابًا. For every Nabi there is a dua that is accepted for him. فَتَعَجَّلَ كُلُّ نَبِيٍ دَعْوَةً. Every Anbiya, they became so hasty with their accepted dua. Some of them cursed their entire Ummah. You know, so Musa cursed Fir'aun, caused his people, all of them, you know. Different kind of dua. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَإِنِّي اخْتَبَأْتُ دَعْوَتِي شَفَاعَةً لِأُمَّتِي وَهِيَ نَائِلَةٌ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ مَنْ مَاتَ مِنْ أُمَّتِي لَا يُشْرِكُ بِاللَّهِ شَيْئًا. I have that kind of dua, but I kept mine for my Ummah. Whoever doesn't make shirk in my Ummah and he died without making shirk, I kept my shafa'ah for that Ummati of mine. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Shafa'ati li ahli al-kabair min ummati. My shafa'ah is for, you know, those who commit greater sins in my Ummah. How many sins we commit? But as long as we don't do shirk, we have hope that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will make shafa'ah for us. Nabi. Ulama praise Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As Hassan al-Basri, the ulama praise Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some of them says Hassan bin Thabit. He praised Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ahsanu minka lam tara qattu ayni. More beautiful than you my eye have never seen. Ajmalu minka lan talidi nisa'u. More handsome than you any no woman has given birth to. Ulqita mubarra'an min kulli aybin. You have been created free from all defects. Ka'annaka qad khuliqta kama tasha'u. As if you have been created like how you wanted to be created. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aisha radiallahu anha says, Linnasi shamsu, shamsun, walana shamsun, wa shamsun nas, yani tatlu bin nahar. People get sun, that rain that comes up during the day. We also got our own sun. Sun, you call it, the sun, ash-shams. But wa shamsun atatlu bin layl. Our sun rises in the night. Aisha radiallahu anha said, I was showing my clothes and my needle fell. And what happened? I said to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I could not see my needle. What happened? Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came. And when Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came, this is two riwaya, one riwaya, this riwaya. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came, Aisha radiallahu anha said, the light, the nur that comes, that emanated from the face of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I could see my needle. The other riwaya said, I was showing my needle. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam entered the house, and because I was looking for my needle in the dark, when he entered the house, I could see that small needle out of the nur that emanates from the face of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, he said, one day I saw Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I say, I can't believe this. He said, wait, and the moon was Laylatul Badr, full time, full moon. He said, I came outside, I look at the moon. I came inside, I look at the face of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I said, let me verify properly. I came out again, and I look at the moon. I look at the moon properly, full moon. You see how sweet and how beautiful it is to look at the moon. Said, I came back, and I look at the face of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I said, Wallahi, the face of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was more handsome and was more beautiful than the full moon. This was Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ulama said, Yusuf Alayhi Salam, when the woman saw him, they cut their hands. If Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has to do that, women will cut their hearts and they will feel it. The time they realized that they're cutting their hearts, they'll slice everything into pieces. This is our Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when it comes to following Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ulama say, if you know, this is my Nabi, and we all know, this is my role model. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Yani, your role model is Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Indeed, there is for you as your role model in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. Whoever wish to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِ. Tell them if you claim to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, follow me. Allah will love you and Allah ta'ala will forgive your sin. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ. It is not right, it is not permissible for every mu'min man or mu'min woman that when Allah Ta'ala decreed something with his Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you come and bring your own opinion. That is not permissible. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. Indeed, the answer of a believer, if he is called with the hukum of Allah and the hukum of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is upon them is سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. They should say سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. We heard and we obeyed. Not like the Jews, Samina or Asayna. It's true, we heard, but we disobeyed. We are not that kind of ummah. Then, are we not scared? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ. أن تصيبهم فتنة أو يصيبهم عذاب أليم. This should be scaring us now. Allah Ta'ala says, those who are going against the Sunnah, against the way of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, let them take this precaution that أن تصيبهم فتنة, فتنة will afflict them, أو يصيبهم عذاب أليم, or a very severe punishment will afflict them. This is enough to make us scared. So when we follow Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, guaranteed. Allah Ta'ala says, if you follow him, you are successful. This is our Nabi. So how can we follow our Nabi? I point the finger on me first. I don't point fingers on you. Go to Shama'il Tirmidhi. Go to Kitab al-Libas. Go to Sifat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The knowledge is with us. If you don't want to go to the Kitab, it's easy also. It's written in English, it's written in Arabic, it's written in Urdu, it's written in every language today. This is how Allah Ta'ala showed mercy to this Ummah. And look for it yourself. How do we finish ourselves when we want to establish our shop, when we want to build our house, when we want to do things for ourselves? We get up ourselves. If you don't want to get up, ask the alim, he'll tell you. So how do I put my clothing? Is it according to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How do I leave my beard? Is it according to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How do I cover my head? I am pointing the finger on me. Is it according to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How do I interact with people? Is it according to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How do I conduct my morning, my evening, my day, my night? Is it according to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? This is a big question mark for you to answer yourself. Ulama said, if I know that, if I do cover my head like Nabi, I am following the Sunnah. I will be rewarded. My success in it, if I clothe myself like Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will be rewarded. I am following the Sunnah. I will be rewarded for it. If I do everything like Nabi, we know. The ulama said, if we know this and we don't follow it still, ulama said, it's like when we know how to swim in the water, in the accident, in the sea, but we choose to drown ourselves. So brothers and elders in Islam, do we know how to swim, but we choose to drown ourselves? Do we know how to save ourselves, but we choose to commit suicide, we choose to kill ourselves? Follow Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For indeed, وَمَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَإِنَّ لَهُ نَارَ جَهَنَّمْ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا. Whoever disobeys Allah and his Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for him is Jahannam forever. You know, one of the Sahaba, Ibn Abbas, Ibn Mas'ud, they were passing by and he just bent his head like that. The Sahaba thought maybe something is wrong with him. They asked him, what are you doing? He said, what? There was a tree in this road here, and this tree, the branch came through the way. And when Nabi Sazam passed by the way, he used to bend his head. Look at that kind of sunnah. It's not even sunnah. Nabi Sazam used to bend his head and pass. Now, the tree was not there. Now this Sahaba said, I do it because I see Nabi Sazam doing it. This is how we must follow our Nabi Sazam. Shibran li shibri. Step by step, handspan after handspan. We are ready to give our life for Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now what did Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put on the Ummah? In Hajjat al-Wada, in the farewell Hajj. This you must listen to properly. And the Ummah forget this. Most of our Ummah, most of the Muslims forget this. They don't only forget, some ulama said they forget that they forgot also. In Hajjat al-Wada, Fair al-Hajj, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah fa'al ballaghtu, behold, did I convey the message? The Sahaba, all of them, 124,000 Sahabi, they said, Atayta al-Amana, Nasahta al-Umma, Kashafta al-Ghumma, Ja'atta fi Allahi, Haqqa jihadi. You have given everything. You gave us Nasiha. What should take us to Jannah? What should save us from Jahannam? You make jihad on the part of Allah, you strive in the part of Allah, you help the deen of Allah, everything, you give us everything. Then Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam point his finger like that and say, Allahumma shhad, Three times, Allah fahal ballawtu, Allahumma shahad, Allah fahal ballawtu, Allahumma shahad. Three times, Nabi is pointing to Allah. Then Nabi said to them, فَلْيُبَلِّ لِشَّاهِدِ مِنْكُمْ الْغَائِبِ. Whoever is present, let him go and convey the message. This is the responsibility that Nabi Sazam want from us. بَلِّغُوا أَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً. Convey from me, even if it is one ayah. So this is our responsibility. If we don't do this, know that the kuffar are doing it, the Christians are doing it, they are calling us towards battle, and some of them are succeeding also. Some of them are succeeding. So let us try our best, make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bring the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and revive the da'wah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, call towards Allah. In support of this, then time up, Allah ta'ala says, قُلْ tell your ummah, هَذِهِ سَبِيلِ. This is my way, adhu ila Allah, calling towards Allah, ala basiratin, with so knowledge, with pure knowledge, with wisdom. Ana wa man ittaba'ani, fa subhanallahi wa ma ana min al-mushrikeen. Meaning, and whoever follows me, this is our responsibility. So this is my responsibility also to convey to you. It is your responsibility to start conveying everybody, to the Christians, to the Muslims, to the Jews, to every humankind, so that Allah save everybody from Jahannam, and make it easy for everybody to go to Jannah, inshallah. Allah give us tawfiq wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah.